Question.
Hi, just a quick question. Do you do voice recordings? I mean, like, can I record your voice on your
tongue? I admire your honesty and your directness. Not here, but we'll be doing an autograph session at 4 o'clock, actually, and I think we can make some kind of accommodation there.
We can yell at you for free.
I was wondering what it was like to work with a new cast for five instead of just with Jack.
Actually worked together. We'd never worked together before. We'd never been in the same room. So Halo 4, we were in the same room together. But before that, we had always worked alone. So we hadn't worked with anybody.
Yeah, no, and that's normal.
Yeah, yeah. It's great, it's fun. Well, I mean, these guys are jerks, but other than that, no, it's really lovely. The cast is wonderful. Well, you still didn't get to her.
No.
I mean, I'm playing Halsey, and nobody likes Halsey, so no, it's not the most, I mean, none of, you know, you guys, none of the characters like Halsey, so it's not the most fun to play a character that nobody likes, frankly, but the cast is wonderful. They're sweet and lovely, and I think happy to be there, and I got to watch some of the stunt team on Manoli's. Your characters become like total badass because you're stunt woman.
My stunt chick crazy. Her name's Natalie. She's amazing. Like
a national gymnast.
Yeah, she's insane. Phenomenal. And for a little bit, I was like, oh, but I want to do someone. Never mind. She's so cool. Just do everything forever and make me look.
I remember one day. I don't know if you guys remember this. They were trying to. You were doing some fancy thing where your character was leaping off of a cliff and killing a whole bunch of people as she did it. And they were saying, okay, like you do it. Yeah, can you, we just want you to go backwards off of this. And she ran up to it's 10 feet off the ground. She's like, okay, like this, and did a back handspring. And they're like, no, a little more. We want your legs to be apart. We want you to do sort of like a back part. And she did, I swear to God, she did 10 different versions of it without breaking a sweat.
Yeah. Okay, like this.
Yeah.
The thing that blew my mind, there was a giant platform in the middle of the room that we probably had like an 8-foot clearance, and they had put a mini tramp, which is this yellow trampoline that's at an angle on the floor. You run up to it, you jump, and it'll propel you forward. And they were like, can you clear this in a variety of ways? So she ran up, she jumps. The first time she puts both of her hands on the thing and does a very parkour Kong over the thing so that her legs come to the outside and she lands in front. They're like, can you do anything else? So she does it again with one hand. And they're like, what if you didn't use any hands? And we're like, yeah, right. She goes, okay. Boom, boom, boom. And just like flies over the thing. We're like, get out of here! That's not normal!
I said something to her too. I said, that is, I'm a man, I can't, and she said, well, I can't talk. She said, I can do bad handsprings, but I sure can't talk. Okay.
Everybody right. Has their
choice. Yeah,
everybody's
got their stuff.
Questions?
No, you're the one. You are the one.
Okay, so, I'm new.
How do we like Halo so far?
Like since you two have played,
we've been working on it
in all the games.
Yeah.
Aren't you just in the new one?
Yeah, I mean, well, you were in Halo 4.
I was, but in the Spartan Ops. Yeah.
You were the jerk in Spartan Ops.
I know. You need a jerk.
I mean, unbelievable franchise. Obviously, everybody is thrilled to be a part of it. When we got cast, we were over the moon just because it's Halo, and we're gonna be Spartans. I mean, it was unbelievable. Yeah. So I can only imagine having this been in your life for so long. I don't know if maybe you get used to it and you don't think about how freaking awesome it is anymore, but it's awesome.
It was a slow burn for us, I think.
I think, yeah, I think really, well,
no,
but I remember when Halo Combat Evolved came out, you know, like we mentioned earlier, voice acting is a relatively solitary experience. It's the, you go into a studio, you get the lines, you read the lines, you're done. And for somebody like myself at that time, it, you know, was not really, you know, part of the video game culture. You know, didn't really, you know, it was a job, it was a fun job, but it was, you went in, it was a couple days work, and that was the end of it. And it was a good 6-7 months later that I was at a friend's house, and the kids were playing Halo, and I said, I voiced a character in that game. And they go, who? And I honestly could not remember his name. It had been 6-7 months, and you know, it came and went. I can't remember his name, but I think he was the main guy. And they said, Master Chief? I said, yeah, Master Chief. Well, within 15 minutes, there's 30 kids outside all with an Xbox or a copy of the game winning autograph. And that was literally the first time I had any idea that this thing was as huge as it was. So, you know, like Jen said, it was sort of this slow burn. You know, I ended up sort of catching up with you in terms of, you know, how big this thing was. It was kind of awesome.
Yeah, in the beginning we would do, you know, for Halo 1 and Halo 2, you would do, a couple days. Well, I had a lot to say. You didn't have to say.
Yeah. Cortana. Yeah.
So you go, you keep standing there, you know, you look and you go. We would go in for a couple days, 2 or 3 days, you know, 4-hour days, and that was sort of it. But now it's very different doing performance capture. You're there on it, you know, you're there for a week, once a month,
yeah,
for 8 months,
yeah,
to a year.
Yeah, how long ago was it that we were cast? I feel like I was cast
over a year and a half ago,
if not 2 years ago. So, yeah. So it takes a lot. It's a very different process now.
And I think, you know, you're usually the voice acting is sort of the last piece of the puzzle.
Part of it.
You know, all the heavy lifting is done by a lot of other people, and then we come along.
We're the stem of the cherry on top of the sundae. Yes. Right.
I prefer the tip of the sword.
Okay. That's hard.
This is from you. Who are you voting for president?
Are we voting for president?
Kanye West, right?
Yeah.
Well done.
Well done. Well done.
Yes.
Thank you.
That's a 2.1.
Kanye the wordsmith.
It's been 3 years and it's
kept
it.
Oh yeah,
that
was
really
good.
That was a pretty remarkable moment in the studio for us both, I think.
Well, I think that's, you know, Halo 4, you know, there was a lot more interaction between the Chief and Cortana and a lot more emotion. And I remember that day specifically. And it was, what I remember is, you know, Jen can turn these things on and off in a way that just blew my mind. And so we're in that very intense scene at the end of Halo 4, and she's just pouring out, you know, this emotion, and I'm trying to, you know, sort of ramp up and keep up with her, and, you know, drawing on things to you know, find that place where Master Chief, you know, Master Chief doesn't cry.
It sounded like
that wouldn't be good.
No, crying in Halo.
No, he short out the equipment. But you know, I'm trying to get to that level, and Jen's doing her part, and we're done, and she's like, okay, anybody got any coffee? And I'm like a puddle on the floor. I can't get off. I'm a complete wreck. But it was fun.
I also had a lot of fun in Halo 4 when they split, when she was popping up as all of the different Cortanas, because I got to play all sorts of crazy voices, and the director just encouraged me to do all sorts of weird stuff. And I don't know how well you can actually hear it, but there are a gazillion different takes of me doing all sorts of crazy. I mean, she was literally like, okay, and now you're Gandalf. And now Cortana as Gandalf. Like, whatever she could come up with. Had a lot of fun creating.
Did you say you shut up?
Yeah, I did. Yeah. Stuffy Cortana. Yeah. That wasn't really my favorite.
Do you have a virus?
Yeah, I
have
a virus.
These are the jokes,
baby. Terrible. Sorry.
You fail.
Hi.
Hello, I'm Neil. Hello, everyone.
Hello,
Neil.
Thank you,
of course. So, I'm primarily like a PlayStation guy, but like I bought the old Xbox to play System Link in my friend's garage for like Halo and stuff. And one of the things we would always do is like, all right, this Friday night, all night, we're gonna play through all of Halo 1, all of Halo 2, all co-op, and we'd all just be like random avatars because it's like only one player to Master Chief. And now you have actually like four like campaign characters. How do you think having actual characters in the campaign co-op will like make that multiplayer all night session like a better thing?
I feel like it'll be much more immersive, just from, I don't know what we're saying exactly, but I do know they said this at E3, so it's allowed. depending on who you have with you, you'll see different elements, or you'll hear different elements about the environments that are around you. You know, so my character speaks Sangheili, so in certain environments, she'll know more about things that are going on than others.
She'll give you a different kind of tour.
Exactly. So it's just cool that can happen while you're playing book.
Yeah, if you're right, if you have my character, he'll just shoot things. So, yeah, it should be pretty interesting. I think they tried to make those characters dynamic.
Yeah.
Yes, I have a question I'd like to ask Travis. Did anybody ever told you, I don't think you ever heard this before, when you do your Knuckles voice, you sound dead on like Scott O'Neill from Viz Media and Ocean Studios?
Scott McNeil.
Scott McNeil, you sound dead on like him when you do your Knuckles voice.
No. That's amazing.
Can you now do your Knuckles voice?
I don't know, it kind of sounds like this.
And listen to Koga's voice, and then listen to your Knuckles voice, y'all that's sound it. Exactly the same.
Well, we'll have to watch that and find out.
You must sound damn handsome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi there. Hi.
I'm very excited to be here. My husband is a huge fan. So much so that my son was born on 1/7.
Well done.
And hindsight.
How did you do that?
I'm sure he'd be a good Cortana.
So my question is actually for you, Jen. Halo is an amazing series with a lot of cinematic depth to it. So my question is, between being captured at Gravemind and going rampant, what was the hardest scene for you?
that, I find, as an actor, that's when you really get to let it all fly and have a great time. So the things that are hard when you're recording something like this are usually technical things. You're not exactly hitting what they want you to get in whatever moment. And I found that mostly, actually, during the Grave Wine scene. It's funny that you brought that up. I could not get what Marty wanted. We did that over and over and over and over and over, and I felt like I wasn't. You know, sometimes you, most of the time, I feel lucky that you can leave a session feeling like, okay, I did that. We got that. We that was good. That was a hard one. That was a really hard one for me. So you called it right there. Yeah.
Hello.
Hi.
I was just wondering, out of all of your characters, probably even Cortana, if you could choose which weapon out of the entire series they could have at all times, which one do you think they would have?
Cortana's just going to eat your brain.
The deadliest weapon of all.
Which maybe wasn't such a good idea since she went rampant.
That's times when I'm like, I love me the sniper rifle, the battle rifle. You can just one weapon.
Just one.
Two weapons. You're two.
Do you want two weapons?
Yeah. Energy sword.
Dual wield.
Energy sword, of course. Energy sword. You gotta be able to sneak up. That's the most.
You want your little.
Well, I mean, yeah, that's her weapon. That she would be able to say.
In the new game, they have a ton of augmented weapons in multiplayer, which you've probably seen.
I always go and pick up a needler when I'm playing multiplayer.
Oh,
just
yeah.
Because they're so
pick up a
what?
Needler.
I suck at multiplayer. That might be why I die all the time.
You don't suck.
At multiplayer.
You're pretty bad.
It's bad. Maybe not as bad.
It's not
as
bad.
Us.
Yeah. I'm old fashioned like that. I like this and I like this. Those are my two favorite masters.
Somebody make out a gift for
me. So Travis, I also want to comment on your Knuckles voice. When I first heard it, I didn't even know that you had replaced Dan Green, the previous voice actor, until like 3 years afterwards.
Oh,
were you
wow.
intending to imitate him? Because you did a very good job at it.
They did originally ask us to try and match the voices that had come before, so yeah, I guess, yeah.
Also, could you possibly, in Knuckles' voice, recite a few lines from his theme song?
From his what?
Theme song.
He has a theme song?
Yeah. You can call me Knuckles. Unlike Sonic, I don't chuckle. I would rather flex my muscles. You can call me Knuckles.
You can call me Knuckles.
Unlike Sonic, I don't juggle.
Unlike Sonic, I don't juggle.
I would rather flex my muscles.
I'm into it!
I would rather flex my muscles.